I was furious with myself when I discovered the secret that I'm about to tell you. Now, I already recently made a video talking about some advanced tricks to use while doing Google searches, but I missed something major. You know how when you Google anything these days, half the page is filled with just garbage you did not ask for? Like the AI overview, ads, videos, this what are people saying section, people also searched for, and a bunch else. In fact, in this case, literally only one quarter of the results space is actual web results. But there is one hidden option, cryptically known as UDM equals 14, which allows you to banish all the slop to the shadow realm and get clean search results pages every time. And of course, yes, I'm also going to show you how you can make it your default search mode. So what is this UDM equals 14 thing and how does it work? Well, it's actually a URL parameter that tells Google to use the web mode for a search. That's right, the good version of Google was hidden in plain sight this entire time, or at least since around May 2024 when they added it. Though sometimes it is hidden in this more menu, you have to click that. Now, while you could go and manually click on the web search mode every time you do a search, that's a real hassle. And that is where the UDM 14 parameter comes in. You see, each of the search mode buttons are simply links to different versions of the Google search URL, each with different parameters telling Google how to display the results. For some examples, I'm not going to get into these, but there are parameters like for the search text itself, your language, any search filters, and a ton more. And that includes the UDM parameter, which decides which of these modes to use. Image search is UDM2, for example, videos is 7, and web mode is 14. So now the big question, how do you make it use this all the time? Before I go over that though, something else that you might be wondering about is how to stop sketchy online data brokers from selling your personal info, which is where today's sponsor comes in, DeleteMe, a data privacy service to which I myself have been a paying customer for over 4 years now, from before they even sponsored. If you've ever Googled yourself, you definitely have seen countless data broker websites who not only collect and display all your personal information, like name, address, and phone number, but then also sell it to companies and other sketchy people to do whatever they want with it. This also makes it easier for malicious people to find and use your own info against you in phishing attacks, identity theft, harassment, and more. But that's where DeleteMe comes in. They do all the work for you in submitting removal requests on your behalf. As new data brokers pop up, they're constantly adding new ones that they remove from. And when you sign up, you get a privacy report showing exactly which sites you were removed from after 7 days and every 3 months after that. You can even submit custom requests to remove your data from hundreds of other sites, and an expert will handle it for you. This includes some surprising sites like berkeley.edu and certain government sites, so not just purely data brokers. Plus, they have other useful privacy tools like email masking and phone number masking for US users. So if you want to get your personal information removed from the web and search results, go to joindeleteme.com/TheoJo or scan the QR code and use the promo code TheoJo for 20% off all consumer plans. And with all that being said, now let's go over how to get the good version of Google as your default search engine. Well, what you can do is change your browser settings so that whenever you do a search with the search bar, which is what most of us probably use, it will include that UDM equals 14 parameter along with your search text, and then it will take you directly to the web results page for that search. The steps to do so are basically the same for most browsers, though on mobile, it's a few extra steps, but I'll show you how to do that as well in a second. On desktop, go into your browser settings and do a search for either search engine or address bar. In any case, we're going to be looking for this page that looks sort of like this that lets us define the search engines. On Chrome, you would go to Manage Search Engines and Site Search, for example. On Edge, you go to Address Bar in Search and then Manage Search Engines. And on Firefox, it's called Search Shortcuts. But again, it should sort of look like this no matter the browser. If you happen to use Firefox, there's an extra step to get this add button to show up. You can just pause here if you use Firefox. You don't have to do this if you don't, though. The next step is essentially the same for all browsers. You just click the add button to add a new search engine / search shortcut, whatever it's called. And you should see some boxes that look like this. You can name it whatever you want. It's just a display name. And for the shortcut box, you could put whatever you want. That really only matters if it is not going to be your default search engine. The URL box, though, is the key. That's the most important one. And in that, you're going to put this URL. I'll have it in the description so you can just copy and paste it. As you can see, it's just google.com/search, and you can put whatever country version of Google you have. Then we add the UDM equals 14 parameter, and then the Q parameter followed by %s, which will be automatically filled in by the browser with whatever text you typed into the browser bar, and that's how it does the search. As an interesting side note, you can see how this compares to the default Google search string built into your browser, which contains a ton of extra crap inserted, mostly used for tracking. And that is why the URL is usually so long when you normally do a search with your browser. Anyway, you can then just set your new custom search engine as the default. And now whenever you use it with the address bar, it will take you directly to the non-crappy results. All right, so that was on desktop. Now on iOS and Android, some third-party web browsers actually make it really easy to set a custom search engine with the string, like Brave Browser and Firefox. They have the same settings boxes that you saw on desktop. For the default browsers though, for both Android and iOS, it's more of a pain because neither have a easy built-in way to set the default search engine beyond the limited built-in list. However, on iOS, I found at least one app called Custom Search Engine, which lets you edit the default search engine in Safari, sort of. It does seem to actually work seamlessly, even with the Spotlight search. You grant it permission in Safari as an extension, and then I think it basically just redirects searches to the search URL to whatever you put in. So it's not technically editing the default search engine for Safari, but it's close enough and you don't notice it, and it is automatic. If you're using Android, your options are going to be either limited or extensive, depending on your phone and whether you're using like a third-party launcher and all that. For example, on Pixel phones that use the Pixel launcher, by default, the Google search bar widget thing at the bottom, there's apparently absolutely no way to change the default search engine for that. Of course, that only applies to the Pixel launcher. I'm not really familiar with Samsung phones. They might have their own search thing that might be more customizable. And of course, you could always go with a third-party launcher, but that would be kind of an overhaul just to change your search engine, at least for the built-in search box. And also, unfortunately for Chrome itself, there also doesn't seem to be a way to change the default search engine to specify it exactly. There is a feature built in where if you search on some sites, it can automatically detect it, but I don't think it does this for specific parameters in the Google URL. Now, there is an app I found called Custom Search Bar Widget that does let you add a custom search URL to use as the search engine for it, and it will open that in your default browser, even if it is Chrome. So that is one way to get Chrome to search through it automatically, but you have to use it through that bar. But again, that's a widget, so it behaves like a widget. I don't think you can by default get it to stay at the bottom on all pages. But again, if you're using a third-party browser like Firefox or Brave Browser, I believe those have their own search widget, which will use whatever default search engine you have configured in that browser. As a quick note, I will point out that I found some information where if you use a managed device, like your company manages it, apparently there is a way that they can set the default search engine in Chrome remotely. That's called using a policy, but I couldn't figure out any way to apply a policy without going through all the enterprise management stuff. So I guess if you use a work phone, you might be able to talk to your IT department and get them to do it if you have to use Chrome. So that probably doesn't help that many people, but I figured I'd mention it. Now, if you were wondering some other stuff I found out about this feature, turns out they added it around May 2024, so not actually that long ago. They, I think, announced it around Google I/O. And it seems that Google did not really want to promote it too much. They only announced it, apparently, on one of their smaller accounts, Google Search Liaison. Though I do find it hilarious how they put it. They go, "We've added this after hearing from some that there are times when they prefer to just see links to web pages in their search results." There are times? Yeah, how about every time? And they've heard it from some, which probably means everyone. So I would be very curious how many of you knew about this before, and are you going to start using it now? I've had it as the default on my iOS and desktop for the past couple days, and it is been so much nicer. So let me know how that goes, and maybe if you have any additional tips that I didn't mention. Thanks again to Delete Me for sponsoring. And again, if you want to have your personal information removed from data brokers, go to joindeleteme.com/TheoJoe and use the promo code TheoJoe for a discount. So if you enjoyed the video, be sure to give it a big giant thumbs up, helps me out. And if you want to keep watching, the next video I'd recommend is where I talked about those other Google Advanced Search tips, which I definitely would say are still really useful. I'll put that link right there you can click on. So thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.